target.
Another person off the gate. Two gators up.
Yeah, three are off.
I've got bodies included. Nobody on the road.
Nearby rogue agent killed. Maybe next time, baby girl.
He said maybe next time, baby girl. This nigga's a bitch, bro. He's so ass.
Yeah, you still talking shit, bro?
He's so ass.
You just got work, bro. Easy. I'm gonna leave you on that L, bro. Again, I'm gonna leave you on that L, bro. Shut the fuck up.
I know you gonna leave.
Yeah, it's only three of us, you fucking dumbass.
You got three too. Look at you. You already making excuses.
All right, so you just got wiped. That's what I said. I'm taking that W, bro. Now you getting butthurt. You getting butthurt.
We can get the ones. How about that?
You getting butthurt, bro. Fuck your ones, bro.
Whatever. Three over here. Are they PVO?
Rogue agent, neutralized.
We gotta always make sure we got the ones getting damaged.
Yeah.
That's what the bulk is for. Seven members never gonna go rogue.
Oh shit! Oh shit! Don't shoot, I'm just a mess!
Yo, yo, what the f*** is going on, guys? This is your main Clever Thumbs, and I'm going to be showing you this amazing build that I've been running for the past couple of days. I fully tested it out. It does justice. You guys are going to see full damage to armor build with the Pestilence. I'm going to be showing you exactly how I achieved this and the way I have it set up. But definitely watch the clips, and if you like it, smash that like button, subscribe. I'm going to see y'all in a little bit. Enjoy this. Watch this Pestilence takes. Watch. If you pay attention throughout the clips, I do get almost to 300,000 on ticks. Peace.
Yeah, I just killed three.
Get that tick off of it.
Wow. Wow. No.
That agent needs assistance.
Do they? Ooh.
Intense.
A push.
What is he planning on doing?
Messiah. They're here. They're pushing right in front of your face, choke. What do you mean? I'm not cooked. Let him push. Let him push. That guy's taken out. That guy's taken out.
Look at that, look at those ticks. Oh yeah. Got beam.
Ay, cabrón.
About to die too, bro. He got the pesky stacks. He's dying from the pesky stacks. Pushing out. Drop your booster. Drop your booster out here. Oh, he's dead to that pesky. Look at that pesky, bro. Did you see that? Nah, they're dying to my pesty, bro. Look at that. They got him on pesties. I did. Got him. Dead. Look at my pesty just, woo, 27, bro. Got him. No? Got one down. Behind us! Behind us! Got him. He's dead.
Agent coming! We're competing, bro. Oh my God. What's going on YouTube? This is your man Clipper Thumbs and I'm back with some more Division 2 build videos. This is actually going to be a different build. As you guys just seen the opening act, this is a hard hitting whatever gun you want to use build. So I used the Pestilence, I used the FAL, I used the FAMAS. Shit, I was even using the CTAR with measured, just like in the back in the old days with perfectly measured when you had that rail splitter. And it hits pretty damn hard. But before we jump right into it, definitely smash that like button, subscribe, and turn on that notification bell. And let's get right into the build video. So I know you guys just seen the build video. I was pretty squishy, but I'm going to show you exactly what I'm running. You're probably looking at my pieces going like, what the hell is all this? Well, I wanted to go a different route, even though it's pretty much the same difference as not having the three-piece Araldi. But yes, that's right, I said it, I have three-piece Araldi. You're probably going, what the hell is three-piece Araldi even do? Three-piece Araldi gives you a 10% marksman rifle damage, which I don't even care about. 15% headshot damage, I go for headshots constantly, so it's gonna help me out. And then that 5% damage to armor. You guys already see that I have two-piece Walker and the contractor, so it has a lot of damage to armor on this build. Before we get into it, I'm going to start down with the specialization. Firewall is going to be your best friend here because that medkit is going to last 10 seconds. It's not going to save you every time, but this in general will help you survive longer because 10 seconds is a long time to just be constantly healing. So the guns that you want to use here, I preferably like the FAO myself. Mine's sitting at 112k. That is right, 112. You're seeing it right. Perfect, beautiful, with in sync. That's the way you want to go.
or at least for me, my secondaries can vary. Since I do have a Raldi, I love the Pestilence. You guys did see the Pestilence put in some work. I got the Eagle Bear at over 100k, like, preferably the Nemesis at 1.8. It's gonna be pretty freaking powerful. As you guys can see, my other guns here, they're basically pretty up there, pretty high in damage. So you guys can use whatever you want. I like the Pestilence. The Pestilence is gonna help me out. It's at 100k basically, and if I am running a, if somebody on my team does have a healer, this FAL goes up to 140k. That is right, 140k with the healer and empathic resolve. But let's break down the build video. So like I said, 3-piece Raldi, 2-piece Walker, and 1-piece Contractors. Basically on every single piece, you want weapon damage, crit chance, crit damage, and your mod slot could be crit damage. I don't have the perfect pieces, but my secondary, which is my chest piece, is that Walker Harris piece. 2-piece Walker Harris gives you that weapon damage and that damage to armor. 13.2 weapon damage, 11.2 critical hit damage, and 5.4 critical hit chance, 11.8 critical hit damage mod slot. And the talents aren't here, unbreakable. Why? Because once you get your unbreakable, you're going to get a little bit more survivability to pop a med kit, take cover, or turn around and fight, whatever you guys need to do while you're face trading. So unbreakable, half of 1.1 is a little over 500k. So I'm basically looking at 1.6 to 1.7 million armor, all said and done with the unbreakable. And then if somebody runs tardigrade, I'm gonna get 40% of 2 million, and that is 800k right there. So 800k on top of that, be looking at like 2.5 million armor if somebody's rocking tardigrade with the unbreakable. 2.5 million armor and you're doing DPS of 4 reds, that is insane. So that's my chest piece right there. My holster is actually going to be the second piece of the Raldi's. It's going to give me that 15% headshot damage. I do not mind this at all. I love going for headshots, gives me more of a challenge. And that on here, I wish everything was max rolled, but it's not. So I got 10.2 weapon damage, 10.6 critical hit damage, and 5.5 critical hit chance. This will do for now. Really like the way the build is set up. Seems a little bit off, but it actually does get the job done. I don't see my damage numbers being too high, but I do see that it chunks more. Don't know. I've been trying to test that theory out, but like, I don't know. It's weird. It's like something's not adding up or something. But anyways, second piece of the Walker is going to give me that 5% damage to armor. You do want 2 blues on this build, 3 blues, whatever you guys want to do. You guys can, you know, fiddle with it and get it to your play style or whatever. But max armor here. I wish I had max crit chance and max crit damage. This is actually dropped. It's probably, I tried to craft one, wasted all my material, pointless. Should just farm for one. But this is what I get for now. The stats could look better, but like I said, you guys might even have a better setup than me. The contractor's gloves, this is why I chose the Pestilence, because it's gonna give me that 10% LMG. Not only that, I got 170k armor maxed out, 8% damage to armor. As you guys can see, I have a lot of damage to armor, 12% critical hit damage. So that's gonna be this, the contractor's gloves, which is multiplicative damage. Damage to armor is multiplicative. Moving on to the last piece. The last piece is actually missing critical hit damage, but it actually has 8.1 headshot damage. So I'm sitting at about, what's that, 22 headshot damage extra on the build so far. And that, like I said, you want max weapon, max crit chance, max crit damage. Headshot damage is not going to hurt. But the mod slot's 11.8 critical hit damage. The talent's Vigilance increases total weapon damage by 25%. Taking damage disables this buff for 4 seconds. You guys should know all about Vigilance. It's not a new talent, but it definitely is new to my playstyle right now with this build. And I definitely like the way this build feels and hits hard. The Pestilence does come with 6% damage to armor. So I'm going to show you the stats. Stats on here for... I actually have 108 headshot damage with 24% damage to armor. You guys can see contractor's gloves, it's damage to armor. The Pestilence gives me damage to armor. The gear sets of Araldi gives me damage to armor. And the Walker and Harris gives me damage to armor, which calculates out to 24%. But to show you the FAL, I'm sitting at 46 crit chance, 140 crit damage, basically 100% headshot damage, and 18% damage to armor. Don't forget, it's at 18 because you don't want damage to armor here. You basically, if you put damage to armor here, it's basically like leaving this damage to targets out of cover at 6%. You don't want to handicap yourself when damage to targets out of cover is multiplicative. Doesn't reflect in your stats, but it's there. So I actually have more than that, you know what I mean? I technically have more than 24, but that's the build right there. It's max PvP weapon damage is 44,000. That is huge. That's insane. Like I said, give the build a try out. It's pretty hard hitting and can intimidate a lot of players because they're going to try and push you aggressively, and you can basically use whatever you want. I mean, if you guys want to try the Eagle Bear, which is going to give you more headshot damage, let's look at the Eagle Bear stats real quick. Swap weapons. Eagle Bear is actually sitting at 108 headshot damage, so there you go right there. I could probably use this right here as well, but it's up to you. You guys can do whatever you guys want to build. For the skills, you guys can use whatever you want. I tend to use a decoy a lot more than any other skill, but the decoy, you can use a defender drone. It's not gonna do a whole lot, but it'll help you a little bit out in these certain scenarios. But this is the build. I hope you guys enjoy it. I hope you guys enjoyed the bonus gameplay at the beginning, and I'll see you guys on the next one. This is your man Clever Thumbs, and I'm signing out. Peace. Smash that like button.